Don't let anything distract you from God's mission. Make disciples. By Acts chapter 6, the apostles have a significant problem. Acts 2, 3,000 people are added to their numbers. Acts 4, another 2,000. Most believe by Acts 6, 20,000 people are now a part of something called the Way. It was too early to call it Christianity. And because Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, nobody comes unto the Father but by me. Most were calling it the Way. Now, there were Hellenistic Jews. They spoke Greek. There were Hebraic Jews. They spoke Hebrew, and they were at odds with one another. One group believed the other group was getting more than they should get when it came to the daily distribution. So the apostles were threatened with division. Now, Lucifer had tried persecution. It didn't work. In Acts chapter 5, he tried the introduction to sin with Ananias and Sapphira. That didn't work. So now it's church division, because Satan knows if he can get you off mission, you'll stop preaching the gospel. You'll stop caring about the lost. Pretty soon the word of God will get watered down, and then you doom the entire congregation to spiritual infancy. So what the apostles did in verse 4 is they met together. They said, it's not right for us to take away from the preaching and prayer of the word of God to wait on tables. It wasn't that waiting on tables was wrong, but it wasn't their mission. So in verse 3, they found some believers who were filled with wisdom, filled with the Spirit, who had good reputations, and they launched to take care of the body. When you rightly fulfill the call and gift set that God has given to you, it allows the Word of God to go forth. Many churches are in business, but they're out of God's business. They're out of God's business because they're given so much to their programs, so much to their buildings, that pretty soon they're caught up in what Jesus didn't command. He said he wants his word preached. He wants you out making disciples, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. When you look down to Acts chapter 6, verse 7, what happened when they rightly delegated their duties? The word of God spread. More people started coming to faith in Christ because they rightly delegated what it was, the responsibility, to those that were gifted. God says in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 5, hey, Timothy, through the Apostle Paul, keep your head in all situations, endure hardship, do the work of an evangelist, discharge the duties of your ministry. Church leaders, church members, if you want to see God go to work, you do what God has called you to do. You allow the word of God to get preached, and then you get out of the way, and you let God, the Holy Spirit, do what he does best. Don't let Lucifer distract you from the main thing. The main thing is the exaltation of Jesus and the proclamation of his word.